Okay, so she is saying that no one would understand a word of my stories. If I will write, I will directly describe my story. I will directly write my story. No one would understand. So I should first give the basics of my life, that where I studied and what about that. Okay, so he is saying that I would provide a brief sketch of my life. Okay, she wanted that she should provide a brief sketch about her life to his daddy. Okay, my father, the most adorable father. She is saying, my father, the most adorable father I have ever seen, didn't marry my mother until he was 36. She is saying, her father didn't marry her mother until he was 36. So at the age of 36, her father got married. Okay. And she was 25 and her mother was of
25.
So my sister Margot was born in Frankfurt, Germany in 1926. What was the name of her sister? She was born where? Frankfurt. Started right away at the Montessori nursery school. Okay, she started from Montessori nursery school. What is Montessori schools? It is the name of school. It is a type of school in which there are three activity is taught. There is a more curricular activities. Okay, like drawing, painting, and sports and whatever, sewing. Lot of things were taught in Montessori schools. I stayed there until I was 6. She was stayed there until she was 6. At which time I started in the first form. Okay, then she get admission in the first class, first form. In the sixth form, my teacher was Mrs. Cupress. Okay,
what was the teacher name?
Cupress.
What it is written?
Mrs.
Cupress, the headmistress. Okay, she was a headmistress there. At the end of the year, we were both in tears, as we said, heartbreaking farewell. Okay, so at the end of the year, what happened? There was a farewell. Means she left the school, and the both teacher and that any both were having tears in their eyes. Okay, at the time of farewell. Now next, in the summer 1941, grandma fell ill. Her grandma fell ill in year 1941 and had to have an operation. So there was operation of her grandmother, and it was her birthday also. So her birthday passed with little celebration. So my birthday passed with little celebration. So because her grandmother was ill, so she celebrated her birthday very normally, means not very enthusiastic. She celebrated. Grandma died in January 1942. Finally, her grandmother died in 1942, and no one knows how often I think of her and still love her. So she was loving a lot to her grandmother, and she is saying that no one can understand how she loves her. This birthday celebration in 1942 was intended to make up for the others, and grandmother's candle was lit along with rest. So again, in 1942, she not celebrated his birthday, and she what we used to give when someone died, what we used to do?
Pray.
Okay. So she was prayed with that is candle and with the rest. Okay. The four of us are still doing well. She is saying the four of us are still doing well. So who are the four one? Four people: mother, father, Annie, and her sister. Okay. So she is saying they were doing well. To make to the present date, that is 20 June 1942. So up to this date, everything was going well. 20 June 1942. Okay. Except her grandmother died. Her grandmother died, otherwise everything was going good. And the solemn dedicated to my diary. Okay, now let's have some question and answer. Understood everybody? So that's why I have written these things. So you have to put your these words in your answers. Okay. Now, raise your hands. Why does Annie provide a brief sketch of her life? Yes.
Annie provide a brief sketch of her life because she no one would understand the word of music. What is the life?
Okay, sit down. Yes.
Anne provided a brief sketch of her life because she knew that no one would understand her feelings or her thinkings, but she want to share with anyone. That's why she gave a brief sketch.
Yes.
Annie provided a brief sketch of her life because no one understands his words from which situation he is suffering from.
if you see directly, you know the heart about the
Correct.
Story, then no one would understand it.
Okay? Sit down. So if she would have directly jumped to the stories about her, then no would have understand it. Because before, unless she tells the basic of about her life, then how anyone could understand, okay? What tells you that Annie loved her grandmother? Raise your hands. Sit down, everybody. Yes, you stand up. What tells you that Annie loved her grandmother? Once again, your turn. So many students have answered it. You have to just repeat that. Okay? What tells you that Annie loved her grandmother? कैसे पता चलता है? What tells you that? आपको कैसे पता चलता है कि Annie अपने grandmother को प्यार करती थी? Okay? तो कैसे पता चलता है? How you come to know? What are the lines that are given in the test? You have to extract that lines. आपको वो lines बतानी है जो test में लिखा है. Sit down. Try to listen. Okay? Now she started writing, okay? So she is writing Dearest Kitty, okay? She is addressing her diary. And the name of her diary is Kitty. So Dearest Kitty, our entire class is quacking in its boots. What is quacking? Yes, shaking. It is shaking. Shaking with fierce and nervous, okay? Shaking with fierce. Okay, let it be fierce only. Shaking with fierce and nervous, okay? So why they were quaking? Let's see. Our entire class is quaking in its boots. The reason, of course, is the forthcoming meeting in which the teacher decide who will move up to the next form and who will be kept back. She is telling it's a result time and the teacher is going to announce who is going to pass and who is going to fail. Yeah. So that's why they were quaking. Half the class is making beds. Jian and I laugh ourselves silly at the two boys and behind us. So half of the class is making bets that I will pass, you will fail, or you will pass and he pass, like that. So all were making bets. What is bet? Okay. Half the class making dates and she, Chian and she laughed themselves to two behind us. They were looking to two boys. They were beating and they these two girls laughed that let's see how they are beating. Okay. Chian and Jackie's who have staked their entire holiday saving on their bet from morning to night. Okay. So these guys Chian and Jackie's. They spent all their summer money. What is he saying? Since we have, yeah, they spent entire holiday money. Okay, entire holiday saving. Okay, the saving they had on the summer season, they saved. They bet it totally. Okay, that who is going to pass or who is going to fail. So they all were betting. No, I am not. Yes, you are. No, I am not. So everyone is saying that, no, I am not. You are. No, you will pass. No, I will not pass. No, you will pass. I am not pass. I have not studied. You will pass. Somebody says like that, means showing that, yes, though he have done well, but he is saying that, yes, I will fail you. You are going to pass. Something this type also happen. Okay. Even G is the pleading glance and my angry outburst cannot calm them down. Okay? Even G is pleading. So her friend is also pleading glances and my angry outburst cannot calm them down. And I am also not able to calm her. Okay? If you ask me, she is saying, if you ask me, there are so many dummies that about a quarter of the class should be kept back. She is saying there are so many dummies in the class, means there are so many dummies, means not so clever student. So she is saying, so there are so many dummies. So many dummies, not means the student, the not so clever, okay? Like I said, like a fool student, means a stupid student, okay? Stupid students. So there are so many dummies that about a quarter of the class should be kept back. Quarter of the class. Any one fourth of the class should be back. But teachers are the most unpredictable creature on the earth. Further, she is saying the teachers are the most unpredictable creatures on the earth. God knows by looking what qualities they promote to these students. There may be promotion which we are not expecting to the students, okay? So he is saying, so the teachers are the most unpredictable creatures on the earth. I am not so worried. She is saying, I am not so worried about my girlfriends and myself. I am not so worried about my friend and about me. That she was sure that she is going to pass, okay? We will make it, means we will pass. The only subject I am not sure about is maths. So she was not sure about maths.
The only subject she was not sure was maths.
Anyway, all we can do is wait. So they can wait only, okay? Until then, we keep telling each other not to lose her, and they will keep telling each other, okay, calm down, don't lose her, don't lose your heart, you are going to pass. Sympathize each other, okay? I get along pretty well with all my teachers, and she is saying that I have a deep bond with each and every teacher. I like each teacher, and every teacher likes me, okay? There are 9 of them, 7 men and 2 women. How many teachers are there?
7.
9 teachers were there. Total 9 teachers were there. 7 of men the, 7 men and 2 women. Okay? Total 9 teachers there. Total 9 teachers were there.
Yeah.
Okay. seven men and two women. Mr. Kissing, the old fogey who teaches math. Now he is describing about his math teacher, whose name was Mr. Kissing.
Mr. Kissing, okay?
Extra homework, and now for this he always assigned her extra homework and essay on the subject. Now maths teacher give him an essay on the subject a chatter box. Okay, a chatter box. So as a punishment, her maths teacher give him assignment to write an essay about a chatterbox. What is chatterbox? Who talked more? Who talked more? Okay. Chatterbox is the meaning of chatterbox is the person who talked more. So she has to write about that person only. Okay? In an essay. What can you write about that? I would worry about that later, I decided. What can you write? She's thinking of what can you write about chatterbox. What can I write about this? This is what the topic he has given to me. But she said, don't worry about this. I jotted down the title in my notebook. She written this title in his notebook. Okay? And tucked it in my bag and tried to keep quiet. And she just written the topic and she just tucked the books and copies to his bag. Okay, tuck means pack, to bag. Okay, she just packed it up. And that evening when she went home, after I would finish the rest of my homework, the note about an essay caught my eyes. Now see, after finishing all the homework, she now sees that note which he have written, the chatterbox. Okay. Caught her eyes. I began thinking about the subject while chewing the tip of fountain pen. See, while chewing the fountain pen, we used to do that. We used to chew our pens while thinking. Ministrants, okay? Ministrant used to chew the pens while thinking. So she was chewing his pen and thinking about the topic, then how she is going to write it. Tip of the fountain. Anyone could ramble on and leave big spaces between the words. She is saying that she is sharing the many ideas how a student writes essays and how try to fool teachers. Means some students, what they used to do, so they leave big spaces in their writing. Like if they write something here, they will leave big space and write there. So that it seems that they are writing, they have written a lot, pulling the pages, filling all the pages and leaving the spaces. Somebody writes very bigger, somebody leave the spaces. Although I also write very big, but this is not my intention. Okay, so she is saying, since some students used to do that, ramble and leave big spaces between the words. Okay. But the trick was to come up with a convincing argument to prove the necessity of talking. But she is saying, but the better idea is to put the convincing arguments. Now she is thinking that I will put the convincing argument. I will write it better way what I think, and I will convince my math teacher through my writing. Okay. Argument to the prove the necessity of talking. She is saying that I will prove her why there is a need of talking, necessity of talking. I thought and thought. She was thinking. I thought and thought. And suddenly, I had an idea. And suddenly, she got an idea. Okay? Yes, stand up. Who gets? Yes. Suddenly, she got an idea how she will going to write the essay on that chatterbox. Okay? What she then done? I thought. See, I wrote the 3 pages of Mr. Kissing's had assigned me and was satisfied. And after she got idea, she wrote 3 pages. Okay? 3 pages in the not in diary. In his notebook. Okay? Writing 3 pages, the essay of 3 pages, good. Okay? So she wrote 3 pages. And she satisfied. I argued that talking is a student's trait and that I would do my best to keep it under control, but that I would never be able to cure myself on the habit since my mother talked so much as I did, if not more than not so much people can inherited traits. So she is saying what she argued, that talking is student's trait. Talking is student's trait. If a student not talk, who will talk? Okay? If the student is going to talk, then he can share his ideas and say there is more productive ideas and in life. Okay? So he's saying this talking is student's trait and that I would do my best to keep control, though I would do best to control it. She was doing best to control it, but the problem is that, but that I would never be able to cure myself, but I was never able to control it. She was trying to control it, not to talk, but she would never able to control it, have it. And what the reason she is giving behind it? Since my mother talked so much. She is believing her mother, because my mother is also very talkative. She talked so much as I did. My mother is so much talkative, that's why I am also very much talkative. As I did. It is genetical, it is inherited. As I did, if not more, then there's not much you can do about inherited traits. She is saying about inherited traits. What is the meaning of this?
Quality of
Genetic. You must have studied at biology subject.
Yes,
that we get something from our parents. Okay, the traits, the qualities that we get from our parents, that is inherited. Okay, in Hindi we say vansanugat. Okay. Mr. Kissing had a good laugh at my arguments. Now, when his math teacher studied his essay. So he laughed. He has a good laugh at his argument. But when I proceeded to talk my way through the next lesson, he assigned me a second essay. Now, after laughing, he assigned him second essay. Okay. This time it was supposed to be an incorrigible chatterbox. And again, he has given the topic an incorrigible chatterbox. What is incorrigible? Something that cannot be corrected. Okay? See, means saying that next time you have to write the incorrigible chatterbox. Matlab the person who never corrected, they always used to talk. You have to write in that topic. I handed it in, and Mr. Kissing said nothing to complain about the 2 lessons. Now again she wrote it also, okay? This topic also she completed and handed over to math teacher, okay? And math teacher had not complained, nothing to complain about the 2 lessons. However, during the third lesson, he would finally had enough he would finally have enough Anne Frank as a punishment for taking for talking in class, write an essay entitled Quack 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 Quack. Now he's again so much annoyed. His math teacher again annoyed, and now in the third time he gave another topic, Quack Quack Quack, said Mr. Chatterbox. So write in this topic also. Okay? So three times he gave him quack quack quack, said Mr. Chatterbox. Now what happened? The class roared. Means they were roared at laughing. Everybody was laughing at the class that the teacher is day by day teacher is getting more annoyed and is giving him more to write, and the students were used to laugh. I had laughed too, and she laughed too. She also laughed too. Though I would nearly exhausted my ignity on the topic of chatterboxes. Now she is exhausted. She is tired of writing the same topic. She is tired of writing about the same topic, and she have whatever she had material about that topic that she already included written it, and then she is thinking what I will write next. Okay, she was completely exhausted. It was time to come up with something else. Now she is thinking that it was a time to come up with something else, something original. She is thinking about to write something original. My friend Sally, who's good at poetry, and he is describing his friend Sally, who was good at poetry.
What was the name of the friend?
Who's good at poetry? So he was good at poetry and offered to help me write an essay from the beginning at the end in verse. Okay, what is verse? So Sally offered him, his friend offered him, I will help you in writing essay, and I will give my poetry to you. I will write a poetry for you in verse. What is verse? It is in rhythm. Okay, so poetry also in rhythm, in rhymes. Okay, it means in rhyme. I will give you beautiful poem. And I jumped for joy, and she was jumped for joy. She was very happy that her friend is going to give help him and will write a poem for her. Okay. I jumped for joy. Mr. Kissings was trying to play a joke on me with his ridiculous subject, but I would make sure the joke was on him. She's saying that Mr. Kissings was trying to make joke on me. She was trying to make joke on me by giving these assignments. But she's saying that I would make sure the joke was on him. That I would do such type of work that she would going to make the joke on him. That is on Kissings, math teacher. Okay. So I finished my poem. So she finished her poem. And it was a beautiful, and the poem was beautiful. It was about a mother duck, and now it was about a mother duck and a father swan with three baby ducklings who were eaten to death by the father because they quacked too much. Now she wrote a story. Okay. Now in this, in writing the quack quack quack, this, in this title, what she done? She wrote a story in which she describes a mother duck, okay? How many ducks was there? Mother duck and a father swan, okay? Mother duck was there and father swan was there with three baby ducklings, and their three babies were there, okay? And what happened at the last? Who were beaten by death? These babies were beaten to death, means they were dead by the father, and father killed them because they quacked too much. Because they were so much quack, quack means the voice of these things, so they were were quaking so much, these babies, that's why their father killed them. Okay? Luckily, Mr. Kissing took the joke right away. And she was written this joke, and luckily, Mr. Kissing understand this joke and took it right way. Okay? Now she has not burani mana, usko sahi way mili. Okay? He read the poem to the class, and now he read the poem to the class. Class mein he read the poem, adding his own comments, and he also added his own comments, and to several other classes as well, and to several other classes as well. Since then, I have allowed to talk and have not assigned any extra homework. Since then, she was allowed to talk. Mr. Kissing allowed him that, okay, you can talk. You are helpless, you cannot stop because this is your inherited qualities. So you can talk at the class and also not giving any extra homework. Okay? He also not used to give him extra homework. On the contrary, what is contrary? Opposite. On the contrary, Mr. Kissing's always making jokes these days. Now, Mr. Kissing's making jokes these days means that there is transition. Kissing, who was a strict man, he did not like jokes, but he started. Yes. He also started making jokes these days. Yours, Annie, extracted from the diary of young girl with slight adaptation. Okay. So now here it ends. Extracted from the diary of young girl. So in the diary of a young girl, it was extracted from there. Okay. And with some slight changes are there. Means what happened when we make any film or anything based on someone's life, then we do some edition, okay, edit, so that it could be good, presentable. Okay, means we cannot say it is totally correct. Okay, like the film we saw about the MS Dhoni. Okay, MS Dhoni, we saw the picture which is on MS Dhoni. So there also there is some the story was not same, as there was some edit was there, so that it would seems better. Okay, so some edit was also there in this. Okay, let's start oral comprehension check. Understood everybody?
Yes,
sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
He assigned the extra homework to her and asking her to write a letter on her letter box.
Okay, sit down. Yes, raise your hands. Yes.
Mr. Kissing annoyed with Annie because she talked very much in the class, and he assigned an extra homework by asking a topic at chatter box.
Sit down. Yes, you. Homework to math teacher. Why? Yes, you.
Mr. Kissing annoyed with Annie because she so much talk in the class, and he assigned extra homework and asking for an essay on our chat box.
Okay. Yes, you.
He was.
Annie justify her being a chatterbox in her essay? Yes.
Can you give to arguments to justify her chatterbox? First, that talking is a student's stress and she would do it. She would do her best to keep it under control. And second, that her mother talked as much as she did. So she could not do about the relationship.
Okay, sit down, sit. Very good. Yes.
According to Annie, she is a chatterbox by the two reasons. First is that it is a student state and she is trying to control it. But and the second one is that her mother is also very talking person, talking woman, and it is a inherited trait from her mother.
Yes, you. Okay, sit down.